25 teams.
16 Olympic medalists.
2 America's Cup winners.
2 Volvo Ocean Race winners.
1 World Match Racing Tour champion.
5 days of racing.
10 boats qualify for the final day.
8 in the quarters.
6 in the semis.
4 in the finals.
$200,000 prize money.
That's our Christmas bonus.
Not in my house.
With this level of sailors, we're all here to win.
And we love this brutal format a lot.
Welcome to the Star Sailors League final. This is the fourth time Nassau, the capital of the stunning 700 coral islands, plays host to a glittering array of the best in world sailing. It is, quite frankly, a dream venue. 25 boats are laid on for the 50 sailors, half qualifying through the Star Sailors League and half invited for outstanding achievements in this varied sport, not least 16 Olympic medalists, a world match racing champion, and this man, Torben Grail, a round the world race winner and 5-time Olympic medalist. Plus Shimei Fantella, fresh from minting a 470 gold medal at the Rio Games. And defending champions Eduardo Natucci and George Szabo, who scooped the biggest chunk of the $200,000 prize fund last year.
It's looking like a windier forecast right now, so we're changing up our tuning from last year and trying things we haven't tried before to go a little faster and breeze. But yeah, definitely our specialty is 5 to 8 knots. It makes it more difficult, make it more crowded at the weather marks for sure. Having, you know, 5 or 6 more boats on the race course is going to make it more crowded everywhere. But it's excellent to have the competition here and have just some of the best sailors here. It's so much fun. It's such clean racing always. It's just really looking forward to meeting all the new guys, and they're really excited about trying out the starboat so far.
Jochen Schumann is Germany's most successful sailor with 2 America's Cup wins and 3 Olympic golds to his name.
Last year we had a fantastic time. I think a beautiful regatta, beautiful venue, and light wind favored a little bit the unexperienced non-star sailors. So we did good in the qualifier. Unfortunately, got kicked out very quickly out of the knockouts on the first race. So now we are coming back, and it would be beautiful if we could achieve something similar. Getting into the finals would be just achieving the best we can dream of.
Robert Scheidt came within a whisker of medaling in 6 consecutive games in Rio. He won here 2 years ago, and now he's back.
Well, I'm pretty excited to be back. After 2 years absent from the class, involved in an Olympic campaign, to be able to come back here. I think this year the field is even stronger than the other years. I mean, it's an amazing lineup with the Olympic medalists and all the legends of the class. So I'm very excited.
Robert came 4th in Rio, a tough result. So wouldn't it be amazing to have another crack at the latest laser gold, silver and bronze medalists? Well, they're all here in an SSL first.
It's so nice to see these laser guys enjoying the star racing. I think it's the best racing you can get these days. And I'm happy to be able to race against them in another boat. I hope they enjoy a lot this week and that more laser sailors come next year.
The SSL format is unique in sailing. All 25 teams compete against each other in 11 races over 4 days. But then on day 5, only 10 make the cut for the quarters, 6 for the semis, and just 4 for the final itself. Unlike the Olympics, whoever crosses the line first in that final race wins the event, whoever second is second, and so on. It makes the final fleet race finale understandable, and as Xavier Rohart says, we love this brutal format. We'll catch that drama later in the show, but for now, here's a summary of the qualifying rounds.
On day 1, race 1 saw a commanding display by Brazilian legend and 5-time Olympic medalist, Robert Scheidt, along with crew Henry Bonning. As the teams got used to the light wind conditions, it was quite a tight battle between Americans Mendelblatt and Fatih, the Italian team of Negri Lambertini, and the Brazilians, ultimately holding tight for the win.
A win for Robert Scheidt and Henry Bjørning.
As the breeze and waves built for race 2, 2 Brazilian teams and the French drag raced up the course.
But it's the French that round first.
Polgár and Coy take an inside line.
In fact, Xavier and Pierre Alexis have overtaken George and Bruno into first place, and that was slick sailing.
The number one seeds took their first win of the event. But it was ultimately the Italians, with a third and a second, who took the day.
We have just to think about the regatta. All these guys, of course, for the first 2 days, they have to think also about the steering, about the trimming, and that's the little advantage that we have in the beginning. But I'm sure that next 2 days, some new guys will be in the top three. I'm sure about that.
Let's see if Diego has it right, and if the younger Olympians can rise to the top. Day two of the Star Sailors League Finals saw the Italians Diego Negri and Sergio Lambertini, who topped the scoreboard. It was a great race as well for the youngest sailor in the fleet, Argentinian Facundo Alezza, taking fifth. Fellow South Americans scored a second, while the Italians held on for the win.
I'm really happy, Matt. Will be not easy to stay on the same level, I think.
Oh, here they go!
The dying breeze meant changing conditions for the teams, adjusting their sailing styles and tactics for less wind.
That is an incredible sight. 16 Olympic medalists all cramming in on one top mark.
Staying mentally sharp was the name of the game throughout the day, and three-time Olympic medalist Slovenian Vasily Spogar, with his Hungarian crew, celebrated their victory in race five. A strong performance on the day with a race win, a second and a fifth, moved the former finals winners, Americans Mendelblatt and Fatih, onto the podium in third overall. The Italians dropped to second, while all top threes moved Brazilians Robert Scheidt and Henry Boning into the lead.
Four tough races today. We managed to hang in there, be top three in all four races. Difficult conditions, difficult to start, but we were pretty happy, especially because we won the last race.
We're now halfway through the qualifiers. Two more days of racing still to go to determine who will go through to Saturday's finals. It was a different start for day three as Light Air greeted the veterans and invitees at the Star Sailors League Finals in Nassau. The teams were chomping at the bit. Halfway through the series now, it's a fight to put the least points on the board.
The Argentinian in absolute trouble right on that mark. Everyone sailing around him. He's lost all his power, all his forward motion.
With the race course closer to shore making current a bigger factor, teams struggled all day to get around the top mark. Race one, it was newbie to star sailing, Rio Olympic gold medalist Shime Fantella and his crew Antonio Arapovic from Croatia, who were able to excel in the light breezes to take the race win.
Great victory for Shime Fantella.
We fine-tuned the boat today and the speed was there. So I would say the key number one is the speed and then the clear air. Overall, we are happy.
All clear,
fabulous stop.
With light air the great equalizer, the VIP invitee teams, the cream of the crop of sailing talent from different fleets around the world, were able to make plays amongst the fleet. But pulling out to a commanding lead was longtime star sailors, Germans Robert Stanek and Fritjof Kleene.
Stanek and Kleene sliding across the finish. They're going to be so happy with that.
We found an ideal line. It's very, very light. The conditions we are seeing here, probably 5 knots. So we were clear off the fleet. And from there on, we found a very good race. And we finished first time in the series.
As the wind dropped to a near whisper, Mendelblatt and Fatih took the race win and the overall lead.
It's
today was a bit of luck, just ending up in the right places and having good lanes. We did get a couple really nice starts today, so that helped a lot. The last one especially put us in good position, but I'm just trying to sail clear air, clear water, and not really worry too much about what side's going to pay, and just focus on the boat speed, and it worked out today.
It's all to play for tomorrow for the 10 spots to make it into the finals. The last day of qualifying at the Star Sailors League finals was delayed by a short postponement waiting for the win.
I don't want to miss any race, so regardless of the result, I want to go and race no matter what.
As the breeze filled, the fleet was off, focused on these final two qualifier races and making the all-important top 10 spot. A shifty 6 to 7 knots greeted the sailors out on Montague Bay, with heat and humidity adding to the high pressure of the racing. Kiwi Olympic medalists Sam Meach and Craig Monk found form after a tough week, leading the race early. Concentration was needed as the holes on the race course wreaked havoc with the sailors. A nail-biting battle developed with the lightweight Croatians, Cantella and Arapovic, squeezing past Meach and Monk for the win.
Super result by the Croatian Šime Fantella, 470 gold medalist, winning race number 10. It's George Szabo heading in, crunching with Sam Meach.
Oh, that's too tight to tell.
Race two, the fight was on, with points tight for 7 teams trying to make the final 3 spots in the top 10. Last gasps of breeze saw big lead changes through the fleet and tight packs at mark roundings. The Croatians Šime Fantella and Antonio Arapovic won again, with fellow countrymen squeaking into the finals, winning the tiebreak for 10.
And I said, let's go on the left side, there is nobody there, then maybe this is the last chance, and it was really like that. I think past 10 boats in second upwind, and thank God we are 10 overall.
Losing that tie for 10th in a nail-biting finish, American Augie Diaz.
Very disappointing not to be able to move forward, but at the same time I recognize that the level here is quite high, and I have to just be content with the fact that I didn't sail well in the last race, and that's what cost me moving on.
Atop the leaderboard now, giving them a bye straight to the finals, is Italian Diego Negri.
So, very happy, but we know that it's not over. We already won the fleet races in Hamburg, in the city event, and then we finished fourth. So, for us, it's been amazing, and let's see tomorrow what happens.
It's all to play for now, for the biggest portions of the $200,000 prize purse in the knockout rounds coming up.
It's crunch time at Nassau Yacht Club in the Bahamas. 10 teams out of 25 have made it through to the last day of the Star Sailors League final, and they face a game of survival through the quarters, semis, and final. The prize for winning the qualifying rounds is a jump to the final itself for Italians Negri and Lambertenghi. Americans Mendelblatt and Fatih, winners here 2 years ago, jumped to the semis. So the remaining 8 out of the top 10 are now in a fight in the quarterfinals. Well, there's the virtual eye view of Nassau on New Providence Island. Northeasterly breeze, we're off the eastern side of the island, a straightforward windward leeward course. Seconds to go, left a picture, Dane Ho Christensen with Stevie Milne getting squeezed out by Stepanovic and Sitchich from Croatia. Flag goes down, off they go for the quarterfinals. Straight windward leeward, 2 laps. Looks like bow number 1, Xavier Rohard and Pierre Alexis Ponso, after a great start there to leeward of the Croatians. Stepanovic poles in clean air.
The other Croatians, Pantella and Arapovic in clean air, Brazilians poking their nose out on the left-hand side as they look up the track. Two crews going right, Ho Christensen, and here we are with Szabo and Natusi, defending champs, the American Italian winners last year, this time. I mean, in the past 3 years, these guys, the Poles, Kuznetsov and Jitski, have been on the podium twice. So ones to look out for as they thread their way upwind to the top mark. Kuznetsov and Jitski now showing a clean pair of heels. Background there, Negrin Labatenghi just training up as the leaders go around this top mark. Dominik Jitski with Matt Kuznetsov, Szabo Natusi in second, Brazilians Schein and Björning in third, fourth, Frenchman Rohard and Ponso, and Ho Christensen up into fifth. So sailing well upwind as we watch Henry Björning, crewman with Robert Scheidt, just preparing for that downwind run. All but in trouble, the Germans, Johannes Polgar and Marcus Coy at the back of the fleet. Remember, five go through, three will get dropped into the semi-finals. Well, there are the two Croatian teams, two medalists from Rio, one in Laser, Stepanovic with the silver medal, Pantella with the gold in the 470. A little battle amongst themselves there, Polgar and Coy in trouble, Rohard and Ponso the deepest going downwind. And now Robert Scheidt jibing with Henry Björning. And these guys beginning to pick up speed on this downwind leg with Szabo Natusi in the background. Henry Björning there, crewman with Robert. Bow stringing that huge main sheet as they head down around the bottom gate. The Poles now in second spot where they've lost a place. But that's fine by them. Top five going through. Defending champs Szabo and Natusi around in third, closely followed by Rohard and Pierre-Alexis Ponso in fourth, winding in that huge main sheet as they steady up for the upwind beat on the second lap. Look like Polgar and Coy beginning to work their way back into the game. Scheidt and Björning now steady ahead of Kuznetsov and Jitski, Szabo and Natusi in the running. Let's see if the Germans are up into fourth or fifth around that top mark. Poles round in second. Nice going by Kuznetsov and Jitski. Well, Polgar and Coy now in fifth position ahead of Ho Christensen, with the two Croatian teams at the back of the fleet. Two VIP guests, medalists from Rio. And there's the hunched view of gold, 470 medalist Shime Fantella. The aerial view looking down beautiful waters in the Bahamas. Fantastic place to sail. Now Jonas Ho Christensen, the Danish sailor with Stevie Milne from Northern Ireland, battling for survival in this competition. They are up against the Germans. Marcus Coy and Johannes Polgar hammering downwind towards the finish line. Polgar and Coy look like they have a slight edge over the Dane and Northern Irishman. As 120 meters ahead, clear in first, the Brazilians, Robert Scheidt with Henry Björning there. Henry congratulating Robert. Oh, what a bunch up for second, third, and fourth. It's Szabo Natusi through ahead of the Frenchman, Rohard and Ponso. And the Poles going through in fourth spot. Mateusz Kuznetsov coolly down there. And in fifth spot, the Germans, Johannes Polgar, Marcus Coy. Lovely job on that last leg. Stevie Milne banging the deck with Jonas Ho Christensen just missing the semi-final.
It's absolutely phenomenal. I mean, we go out here today, we have eight boats on the starting line. I think there was five world champions in the star. A couple of Olympic gold medalists from Rio and then us. So we were we're in a tough crowd and we did our very best. And big thanks to Michelle and everybody at SSL, because I mean, this is truly a phenomenal experience.
Well, just making that top 10 cut is a result for Ho Christensen with Stevie Milne, and same can be said for Stepanovic and Sicic and Fantella and Arapovic, VIP guests. Now our remaining characters will face Mendelblatt and Fatih, who won this event a couple of years back. Brian Fatih, the big crewman, Mark Mendelblatt,
great star sailors. And here we go into the semis. Polgar and Koi Kuznetsov-Zhitsky going for the committee boat end. The far end there was Mendelblatt and Fatih Bao, 17. In the middle, George Szabo, Eduardo Natucci. So an even start across that line. Oh, look at the Frenchman on the left-hand side getting squeezed out. That is a second-row start. They can't afford that. They are being dictated to now, having to work their way to the right-hand side of the racetrack. Well, let's see how that pans out towards the top mark. Big separation by the Frenchman, as the Brazilians, Scheidt and Björning, tack, beautiful crew work underneath that boom. Oh, and look at this, towards the top mark. It is Rohard and Ponceau first into the top mark, just ahead of the poles, Kuznetsov and Zhitsky, and Mendelblatt and Fatih threading their way into third position. Three boats go through to the final. Three boats will be dropped at the end of this simple windward-leeward race. The Germans there in trouble, as are the Brazilians, Henry Björning and Robert Scheidt. Well, these guys seem to have an extra gear downwind. Let's see what they can do on this downwind leg, as Szabo and Natucci, defending champions, bring up the rear. Well, they are well out of it right now. Polgar and Koi in trouble. But look at that lineup of three boats behind Rohard and Ponceau, battling for survival in this competition. Rohard Ponceau leading the semi-final. They are beginning to command this final day. Brilliant sailing by the Frenchman. Brazilians coming round. Oh, they managed to squeeze ahead of the poles. Szabo and Natucci in fifth spot. They are battling for survival, as are Polgar and Koi. So only three go through, very tight in second, third, and fourth. Polgar and Koi, a lot to do. On the final downwind leg now, poles. Kuznetsov and Zhitsky neck and neck with Mendelblatt and Fatih. That is super close as they go down towards the finish. Mendelblatt and Fatih in a bit of trouble as well. Well, through the finish line, Xavier Rohard. Look at that lovely big smile there. Shaking the hand of Pierre-Alexis Ponceau. Bravo, les Français. Second through in the semis, it is the Brazilians, Scheidt and Björning. And here in third and fourth, the Americans, Mendelblatt and Fatih. Mendelblatt just stuffing the poles up into the committee boat. Then bang, they've hit. They will have to do a penalty turn. Wow, that was an aggressive move by the Americans. Mendelblatt, a great match racer. Whoa, he's fired up there. And unfortunately for Kuznetsov and Zhitsky, that is them out of the finals. You could see how much that means to Mateusz Kuznetsov. Well, so that's the poles, the American Szabo, Natucci, and Polgar and Koi out. The top three going through to the finals. On to the final now, and they're joined by Negri and Lambertenghi, the Italian Navy, who won those qualifying rounds. And here they are for the first time today. They've been working their way up and down the beat, watching very closely. And we can see them in the middle of the pack. Four boats on the final line. Rohard and Ponceau, committee boat end, with Mendelblatt and Fatih. The Italians in the middle. And it's the Brazilians on the pin end. Well, can Robert Scheidt make this another win? He won this first event 3 years ago. Mendelblatt and Fatih won 2 years ago. And here are the Frenchmen, meaning business, winners from the first ever Grand Slam in the city in Hamburg. Italians tacking over, working their way up when the sun is out in the Bahamas. Beautiful conditions off the eastern side of New Providence Island. The Italians going for the right-hand side of the track. They must have seen how well it paid off for the Frenchmen, and now they are gunning for that same strategy. big separation for the Italians. Medelblad and Fatih playing it safe in the middle. Scheidt and Björning on the left-hand side. Scheidt just looking around, seeing who's behind him. Rohard and Ponceau coming in on that ley line, but it looks like Scheidt and Björning about to round that top mark. First spot, there he goes. The Brazilian team of Scheidt and Björning. Around they go, ahead of Rohard and Ponceau. Whoever wins this gets the lion's share of the $200,000 US prize money, $40,000 for the top prize. So a lot of money on the table here between these places. Oh, and what a shocker for the Italians at the back, Negri and Lambertenghi. Now neck and neck, almost heading downwind. Ponceau and Rohard with Mendelblatt and Fatih. Scheidt and Björning with that extra gear downwind. Super close for second position here in the SSL final in the Bahamas. At the moment, it is Robert Scheidt and Henry Björning with a clear lead. Mendelblatt and Fatih now beginning to breathe down their necks, pouring their dirty air onto the Brazilians. Wow, great match racing duel going on at the front. We'll have another lap after this bottom gate, but it looks like Mendelblatt and Fatih rolling the Brazilians downwind. Well, it's not often Robert Scheidt gets overtaken on a downwind run. He's looking concerned, talking to Henry. What's going on? What can they do? As they jibe around for a simultaneous mark rounding at this bottom gate, the Frenchman going through a couple of boat lengths behind. Very close in this final. Pierre-Alexis Ponceau pulling in the mainsail and the jib. Oh, and some lovely lee bow tacking by Mendelblatt and Fatih, match racing the Brazilians. Look at that. How close is that? Scheidt and Björning having to tack away, putting in extra tacks and losing speed over Mendelblatt and Fatih. The Frenchman in their own clear lane. Oh, and it's the Frenchmen who have taken the lead. So we've had three lead changes so far in this final. That's extraordinary. The Frenchmen have left Mendelblatt and Fatih and the Brazilians to their own little match race and clawed their way up into first place. Big smiles by Xavier Rohard, the bronze medalist in the Finn, as they go around top, just followed by Mendelblatt and Fatih, about two, three boat lengths behind, super close at the sharp end. Well, super tight around the top mark now. On board with the leaders, Rohard and Ponceau. In the background, you can see second placement Mendelblatt and Fatih now beginning to work their way downwind. Brian just talking to Mark the helm, seeing what's coming down behind them. More breeze, perhaps, because the Americans are certainly working their boat a lot harder. They seem to have a slight edge over the Frenchmen. Xavier Rohard chatting to Ponceau, his crewman, and Mendelblatt and Fatih just chewing 30 meters out of the Frenchman on that final downwind leg. Astonishing performance here, perhaps into a little puff of breeze behind them, but certainly working their boat much harder than the Frenchman. What a fantastic finale for Mark Mendelblatt and Brian Fatih, winners of the SSL finals for the second time in 2 years. Congratulations. Oh, Xavier Rohard waves to the committee. Big hugs to Pierre-Alexis, just losing it on that final downwind leg. The Brazilians, Scheidt and Björning, very well done, coming in onto the podium in third. Oh, and the Italian Navy, Sergio Lambertenghi, already shrugs. What can you do? Sergio and Diego Negri off the podium in that terrible fourth position. And here are the final results. The top four there. Johannes Polgar in fifth with Marcus Coy. Szabo Natucci just out. Kuznetsov and Jitski ended up seventh. Jonas Ho Christensen, Stevie Mill in eighth. Stipanović Sičić in ninth. And the other Croatian VIP guests, Šime Fantella, the gold medalist, remember, with Antonio Arapović in 10th. Diaz and Boltins 11. Oleksa Melo 12th. Zbogar and Berec, the Slovenian-Hungarian duo, in 13th. Staniek and Kleen, 14th. Paul Kayard with Josh Revkin in 15th.
the New Zealanders Sam Meach, bronze medalist in the laser with Craig Month in 16th, and Taylor Canfield, 2013 match racing champ with Mark Strube, a stalwart of the SSL, and then Torben Grail, a Brazilian legend, 5 Olympic medals with Guillaume de Almeida in 18th, Munin and Rambo 19th, Jochen Schumann, 4-time Olympic medalist with Ingo Borkowski, the Germans, Zarif and Prada, the best SSL crewman around in 21st, Nick Thompson, Stevie Mitchell in 22nd, Payne and Coleman in 23rd, Tom Burton, gold medalist in the laser with Andrew Palfrey, the dog, in 24th, and then our great doctors, Dr. Hubert Merkelbach and Dr. Klaus Ullerson, the German-Danish duo in a creditable 25th, our amateur crew there having a great time at the SSL finals. But it is the Americans, Mendelblatt and Fatih, champions of the SSL final for the fourth running of this event. $40,000 paycheck. Thank you very much. Superb racing on that final leg.
Winning this event is always a big uncertainty because it comes down to the last race, if you can even get that far and you're standing against these guys. So you never really know what's going to happen, but we just decided to stay calm and do our best, and Brian did a great job all week, so to win here again, it feels excellent.
Well, worthy winners amongst an incredible fleet here in the Bahamas. Keep your eyes out for more Star Sailors League action coming soon.